नमस्कार मित्रों, मैं राजीव मिश्रा सोशल रिसर्च फाउंडेशन में आपका बहुत बहुत स्वागत करता हूं और आपको बताना चाहता हूं सोशल रिसर्च फाउंडेशन उच्च शिक्षा में शोध प्रशिक्षण के लिए लगातार तत्पर रहता है और इस क्रम में हम 6 अंतर्राष्ट्रीय रिसर्च जर्नल्स का प्रकाशन लगातार कर रहे हैं। मित्रों, जर्नल्स की जो गुणवत्ता है उसका प्रमुख कारण है हमारा रिव्यू प्रोसेस। हम अपने पेपर को डबल ब्लाइंड पीयर रिव्यू पद्धति के आधार पर रिव्यू कराते हैं, तमाम एक्सपर्ट्स के पास भेजते हैं और उनके द्वारा अनुशंसित होने पे ही वो पेपर आगे प्रकाशित होता है। इसी कड़ी में सोशल रिसर्च फाउंडेशन ने एक नई शुरुआत करी है, वो है ओपन वाइवा। इस क्रम में हम जूम मीटिंग के तहत एक्सपर्ट और लेखक को आमने सामने रख कर एक साक्षात्कार कराते हैं, जिसमें दोनों एक दूसरे से अनभिज्ञ होते हैं, खाली उनके पेपर एक दूसरे के पास होते हैं और वे अपने पेपर पर एक डिस्कशन करते हैं एक्सपर्ट से और एक्सपर्ट उस पेपर पर साक्षात्कार पद्धति से डिस्कशन करने के बाद पूरी तरह जब संतुष्ट हो जाता है तब वह पेपर हम अपने जर्नल में प्रकाशन के लिए भेजते हैं। तो आइए हम अपनी तरह का पहला अभिनव प्रयोग करते हैं रिव्यू प्रोसेस के लिए ओपन वाइवा के रूप में।
यस मैम,
सर आप अपना कैमरा और स्पीकर ऑन करिए और अपने पेपर के बारे में कुछ बताइए ताकि एक्सपर्ट उस पे क्वेश्चंस कर सके।
हेलो, गुड आफ्टरनून ऑल ऑफ यू। आई एम तपस कुमार पत्रा एंड आई सेंड माय टॉपिक दैट इज प्रॉब्लम्स एंड प्रोस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ रूरल आर्टिसंस, ए स्टडी ऑन बाम्बू क्राफ्ट्समैन ऑफ ढेंकनाल डिस्ट्रिक्ट परजंग ब्लॉक। This paper is based on the bamboo artisans of Odisha, particularly in the district of Dhankanal. And in Dhankanal district, there are 8 blocks, and I have selected my own block, that is Porjang block, from where I have collected 75 samples. And my study is based on what are the problems and prospects they are facing. मैम, योर वॉइस इज नॉट ऑडिबल।
जी आप बताइए, वी आर हियरिंग यू, आपकी आवाज आ रही है, हम सुन पा रहे हैं।
मैम, आई हैव कलेक्टेड 75 सैंपल, 25 ईच फ्रॉम 3 डिफरेंट ग्राम पंचायत। वन इज पाटरपदा विलेज ग्राम पंचायत, आनंदर इज सांदा ग्राम पंचायत एंड आनंदर इज लोधोनी ग्राम पंचायत। And 25 sample each, that is total of 75 sample has been collected from 3 different villages. And my study is based on that, whether what sorts of problem they are facing, whether any credit facilities are available to them or not, any training available is to them or not, what are the government policies provided to them, and whether they have availed all those facilities or not. And my study, in that study, I have found that most of the bamboo artsmen, they are not properly trained, and due to which they are producing some traditional bamboo crafts, which is not accepted by the public or the people, because in this the era of globalization, almost all the people, they are trying to get something new design and some technically new products. But as they are not trained, they could not produce such typically designed or technically new designed product. And what sort of their product they are producing, it is not properly accepted by the people. And another thing I want to say that the credit facilities available to them. Actually, government has the facilities to provide credit to all the rural artisans. But as they are not educated properly or trained properly, so they could not know properly whether how to avail the credit and how much to avail the credit. And they could not approach the bank or any other financial institution so as to get the financial assistances. एंड द सो दे कुड नॉट गेट द फाइनेंशियल असिस्टेंसेस ड्यू टू विच दे कुड नॉट प्रोड्यूस द प्रोडक्ट एंड समटाइम्स इन द ड्यूरिंग द कोविड लॉकडाउन आज दे आर नॉट अलाउड टू गेट आउट ऑफ देयर होम दे कुड नॉट सेल देयर प्रोडक्ट आज देयर इज नो पर्टिकुलर मार्केट फॉर देम लाइक दिस सो माई पेपर इज बेस्ड ऑन and I have found that the studies most of the rural bamboo artsmen are not properly trained and what sort of material they are using for their product those materials are not available in their rural area so I have analyzed it one thing the male member and female member of the family as they are in raw materials is not properly available so the male member of the family they are going to nearby villages so as to collect the raw materials by paying some amount and they are bringing the raw material and the female member of the family they are engaged to make the bamboo crafts and after making the bamboo crafts they are going to sell their product to different nearby villages as there is no particular fixed place of market so thank you
सर आपका पेपर बहुत अच्छा था आपने उसे बहुत अच्छे से डिस्क्राइब किया नाउ आई वुड लास्ट टू आस्क टू आवर रिव्यूअर्स टू गिव देयर कमेंट्स आवर रिव्यूअर्स और एक्सपर्ट्स आर देयर प्लीज आस्क इफ यू हैव एनी क्वेरी डॉक्टर हरिप्रसाद सर आप लाइन पर हैं आप पेपर देख रहे हैं अगर आपकी कोई क्वेरी हो तो यू कैन आस्क
जस्ट मिनट मैं पेपर देख नहीं पा रहा हूँ जस्ट मिनट
ओके
आप विच रिसर्च मेथोडोलॉजी पे फॉलोड
सर बेसिक मेथोडोलॉजी लाइक नो पर्टिकुलर स्टैटिस्टिकल टूल आई हैव नॉट यूज्ड जस्ट आई हैव कंप्लीटेड द दिस आर्टिकल यूजिंग टेबुलर फॉर्मेट एंड ग्राफिकल एनालिसिस ओनली ग्राफिकल एनालिसिस हैज बीन डन हियर
एंड हाउ मेनी इयर्स डाटा यू हैव टेकन
द डाटा इज कलेक्टेड फॉर द करंट ईयर ओनली सर फ्रॉम 2019 एंड 20
99
and all the data is only primary data
all data are primary
yes sir
okay what under your literature review I could not see your paper for literature review how many years you have taken
I have done for 10 years sir literature review
literature review so any research gap in your study
Yes, research gap in my study, sir. Many studies has been done regarding the rural artisans, but no particular study has been done on bamboo craftsmen of a particular in Odisha state. So I have done the study on bamboo craftsmen, not as a general of handicraft sector or handloom sector, and basically I have done my study on the bamboo craftsmen of Porjang block, that is in Dhenkanal district of Odisha.
Limitation
of my study that they are not getting any training facilities available in Odisha there are training clusters particularly in one district that is in Moyurbhanj district where most of the people are SCST and they are availing their they are going through the training because in Moyurbhanj district only it is the training center conducted But in the Dhenkanal district, there is no particular training center, so they are not getting proper training facilities. And second thing is credit facility. They are not getting any crediting facilities. As they are not properly educated, they don't know how to avail the credit and where to go and how to avail the credit. So they are not getting any. And another thing is the government facilities. Government has many schemes who has to help them. But as they are not educated, so they don't know how to avail the government schemes. And another thing is that during the COVID-19 pandemic, as there is they were not allowed to go outside of their home. They could not sell their product as there is no fixed place of market. So So one of the most major limitation is there is no particular fixed place of market for them so as to sell their product.
The final findings of the study or
the finding of the study is that sir, they are not first of all sir, they are not getting any training facilities. Second, they are not getting any credit facilities from any financial institution or government schemes. And another thing is that they are not only engaged in their primary occupation so as to provide bamboo product, as there is no particular or fixed income for them so as to earn their livelihood, they are also opting for a different livelihood. They have engaged themselves in agricultural activities or different other allied activities also.
So, okay, over. Thank you. You have nicely defined.
Thank you, sir.
Over to any other reviewer.
Sure.
Any other reviewer is not present, I think, right now due to network connectivity or any other reason. So I think now this paper, sir, according to you, this paper is approved or not? We should approve this paper or not?
You are asking myself? Or
yes, I am asking you only that this paper, we should approve.
This paper was not sent to me actually.
Okay, so I will send this paper to you, but you have heard all the discussion about the by the author. So I will also send this paper to you on your mail ID, then give your comments over there. Okay, sir, thanks to all of you.